All right, this is part three, so let's just go ahead and get started with this. I've copied down on a second piece of paper here the adjacency matrix and the formula that we're using to compute the optimal path at each stage of our network as we go from the destination back to the original stage. The final stage, the first stage. So the final stage is F5, so the optimal cost to go from the only node, the only S in the final stage 5, is 0. Okay, that's easy enough. Now in stage 4, we can see right here, I have two nodes right here that are in stage 4, H and I. So in stage 4, just using this formula right here, I'm going to compute the optimal cost to go from node H, so my S will equal H, is the min over all the Z that's in stage 5. There's only one Z in stage 5, that's J, so there'll only be one of these that I have to worry about. The cost to go from H to J plus the optimal cost to go from stage 5, my node J. Okay, so that equals the min. There's only one of these nodes. There's only one of these Z's. So those overall Z's, right? All the Z's in stage 5. There's only one of those Z's. That's J. So it's the min. So there's only one thing to calculate. The cost from H to J is 3. Plus the optimal cost is 0. So that equals 3. So that takes care of H. Let's compute for stage 4 the optimal cost to go from the other node in stage 4, which is I, will be the min, the cost from I to J, plus the optimal cost at the stage 5 to get to node J. And then I calculate. Okay, so I've got min of Cij is 4 plus 0 equals 4. Okay, at stage 3, I'm going to have three nodes right here. So let me go ahead and make myself have room down here. So the cost at stage 3 to go from, here's my stage 3 nodes right here, stage 3. So I have a stage 3 node E equals the min over the cost from E to all my nodes Z in my next stage. I have two nodes in my next stage, so let's just pick the first one, H, plus the cost to go stage 4 from node H to my destination. So that takes care of one node that's in stage J plus 1, right? I've got one of these things right here. I also need to look at the other node from E to I. So the cost from E to I is my second node Z, plus the optimal cost. Okay, and I only have the two nodes. I only have two nodes in Z. Here's my node Z in my stage J plus 1. Here are my nodes S, and I'm currently looking at node E. So this equals cost E to H is 1. So I'm looking at the min 1 plus the optimal cost from H to the destination F4H I just computed right here is 3. Okay, cost EI is 4, plus the optimal cost from I to the destination, F4 of I is 4. And that's minimum between 4 and 8, so that'll be 4. Okay, so what that tells us here, that at this point right here, if I'm going from E, then I want to go from E to H to J. So I want to go E to H and then H to J, because that is the cost of 1 plus 3 is 4. Okay, let me flip to a next page here so that I can continue this. I'm going to be needing to flip back and forth between these two things probably, but let's just go ahead and take a look at that. So before I do that, the next node I'll be looking at is F3 of F. Okay, so I have here F3 of F. So my S is F equals the minimum over all the Z's in J plus 1. So this is my stage 3. This is my stage 4. So I'll have the cost from F to H plus F4 from H. That's 1. And then I'll have the cost from F to I plus the optimum cost F4 from I to my destination. Okay, so that equals the min of F to H, the cost from F to H is 6, plus the cost from H to my destination. I calculate, I don't have to look that up because it's actually, I can see it right there. Cost from F to I is 3, plus the cost from I to my destination is 4, so that equals 7. Then I have one more to calculate at this point. That would be G equals the min, the cost from G to H plus F4 of G. I only have two nodes Z in stage 4, H and I. So that's a comma. The cost from G to I plus F4 of I. So that's the min. G to H is 3 plus, this is F4 of H. H to J is 3. G to I is 3. F4 of I is 4. So that equals 6.